So, Halloween is only 3 days away. And if you're like me, you have great intentions all year thinking, this year I'm really gonna go out for Halloween. I'm gonna do a whole bunch of stuff. I'm gonna make the house really scary. I'm gonna get super into the spirit of it all. And I'm gonna go all out with a costume and everything. And then October 28th rolls around and you realize that everything looks exactly the same as always. You have done literally nothing and you have no costume planned whatsoever. I kind of had in my mind that maybe I could just do like a Keiko from Allegiance or something like that, put on like a red dress and fold the little paper flower, you know, all that kind of thing. Turns out I have like no dresses that work for Broadway inspired girls at all. I just, like, I have nothing. I can't even do like a white, there's no white dress. You can do a lot of stuff with white dresses, spring awakening, things like that. I got nothing. But what I do have is a newsboy cap. So I followed the advice of Andrew Keenan Bolger and decided to be a newsie for Halloween. This is an outfit I threw together in about 5 minutes earlier. This cap, we got shirt from my brother's closet. Right, vest, whole thing, little messenger bag, boots, of course. And then, with the costume all set, next thing we gotta do is do some sort of something in the spirit, right? We don't really decorate the house much. We'll probably put a pumpkin outside. We don't get any trick-or-treaters up in this area anymore. We used to, but I guess we don't have the proper generation of kids anymore right now. On the bright side, though, normally I have to do kind of like a stealth costume at work. Like last year, I did Supergirl and I just kind of wore it underneath work clothes, right? But this year, my boss is actually going to be away all day. So I'm going to be the only worker at the store this year. So I'm thinking maybe I'll actually go in costume. Not like any of the customers are gonna care, right? All right. So what I was thinking was I would make some sort of baked good in a Halloween decorated spirit, because I've been watching the Halloween Baking Championship. I always like decorating things like that. Don't do it very often, but I'm not that good at it when I do. But I think it's pretty fun, so. Like the costumes and preparations, I just basically don't prepare in advance at all for anything. So when I was trying to decide what to make, I just had to kind of look around at what ingredients we had lying around the house. And I found three apples, kind of oldish. I was like, all right, no one's gonna miss this. It's kind of squishy, just use it for baking. So I'm gonna be making like a apple pie. Figured I'd do some sort of like a creepy hand sort of thing, like a Mrs. Lovett's meat pie or something like that. Although it's not gonna actually be meat, it'll be apple. I already prepared some of the ingredients earlier in the kitchen, so let's head on over there. All right, so here is my little dough here. It's all stretched out. And I'm gonna, oops, put some in this pie pan here. So, just gonna flop that over. What I did was actually I used a strudel recipe, so that's why this is all so papery thin here. Because I just wanted it to be mostly apple. I'm thinking that might have actually been a mistake. Maybe I should have done the usual pie thing, but whatever. All right. Here I've got my apple mixture. I'm thinking I want it to be really kind of gory, so I'm gonna add some red food coloring to make it kind of bloody and like these are just chunks of flesh or something. It should be a little bit darker than that. Actually, I'm going to add some black too. Ooh, too much black. Too much black. It's all right. Instead of a human person, it'll be kind of just a, maybe like a witchy creature that's getting boiled up. Maybe like a messed up Hansel and Gretel kind of thing. Gross. Just gonna brush a little butter in here. Sprinkle in some nuts. Here's where they get some decorating in. I'm gonna make some fingers out of this dough here. Put an apron on over this newsy outfit. There we go. It's like Jack with his paints. Ha ha.